as the buyer, we love to be in that position of when we find ourselves in the under-promise, over-deliver side of the equation, where we hired a product, we hired a service, we purchased a product, and what we ended up really receiving was so much better than what we were expecting. Well, it turns out there's actually a very simple formula to do that. If you can meet this criteria, that if you can sell people what they want, and in the process of, yes, delivering what they want, also then give them what they need. Right there's the formula for under-promise, over-deliver. So let's set that off to the side, because that's one of the building blocks of this language pattern I'm about to share with you, which may sound like a bit of a mathematical equation, but after you've heard me give a few examples of this, it's very easy. So the pattern is this. And what this solves the problem of is when you're in a service or a product industry where unfortunately someone could look at you as a commodity, that solves a similar problem that someone else can resolve. So how do we stand out in the crowded marketplace? How do we position what we do as being better, if it truly is? Here's the sequence. It's not about X, though we're definitely going to X. It's also about Y, so that you can Z. So it's not about X, though you are going to X. It's also about Y, so that you can Z. Let me put this into the context where about 2 weeks ago, suddenly I had three people in the same industry call me at the same time, which was, there must have been something in the news. They were all credit repair specialists. These are people that if you have, you know, some missed payment on your credit report, which is damaging your score, these are the people that negotiate on your behalf to get that cleared away on that credit report. So all three of them independently noticed the same problem in their business, which might sound like a good problem. Their clients kept coming back to them. But what that really meant was they weren't really helping these people. They maybe put a Band-Aid on the one mistake the person made, but the person made the problem again. So really, they needed a bigger solution. So here is that formula as I talked through with three of them. Here it is. So it's not about credit repair, though very clearly we're going to help you repair your credit. It's also about changing your emotional relationship with money so that you never need a service like mine again. Makes sense? So what we're doing there is we're setting the expectation of that under-promise, over-deliver. And inside of it, the beauty of the last transition, so that I meet too many people in business that throw out on a website or a brochure or a sales page the big list of all the features. As the buyer, you need to step into the mindset almost from a respectfully cynical place to ask, for every feature, well, so what? And the easy way to solve that is the pattern of language, so that. So if a person is shopping for credit rapport and they suddenly see the listing of change your emotional relationship with money, they're like, that's not what I'm looking for. But in that sales process, we land this phrase. So it's not about credit repair, though really we are going to help you repair your credit. What the process is really about is changing that emotional relationship with money so that you never need to hire the service again. The moment we have delivered something of that nature, everyone else is selling a commodity. Everyone else is offering a service. You are providing a solution, which chances are might have been what you were actually doing in the first place. Yet the difference is now we've presented it in such a way that now we stand out in a crowded marketplace. We break through the overwhelm,